Well, another round, another scapeshift deck. This would be the third scapeshift deck I've played in a row. But this hand is okay. Again, game one is just not that great, so. Hopefully this guy. Well. My opponent suggested that I record some extended matches, so I informed him that I was, in fact. Let's see what happens here. In case you're wondering why I always knew what my opponent was playing, well, you should be able to watch replays. Which means you should pretty much always watch your opponent's replays to know what they're playing. After, of course, round one. Round one, you know, I didn't have any idea, but. I don't think I would mulligan this against very many decks, so. He chose to not shuffle. Unfortunate. Ghost Core is not usually too relevant, although I would have won game one against the other Scapeshift deck had I won more life. Because I could Ghost Core to one of his Valakuts. I think in general it's worth spell snaring here. Oh, well, or not. Definitely worth getting out a Thopter Foundry while I can. I've got plenty of artifacts to discard to Thirst. And having this on the board means if I Thirst into a sword, I can, you know, assemble the combo without ever tapping out on my turn. Alright, he's got some action on a wood elf or something. Ooh, even the Exodus wood elves. Some style. Well, I can't cast Tezzeret this turn. What I can do is just main phase a Thirst, and I don't see a reason not to. There's not much he can cast on his turn that I can would either care about or can do anything about. Here, I think I actually like discarding Seat. I might have a use for Chrome Mox. Like if he taps out playing a Tezzeret next turn. I mean, I suppose he could search, play a land, play another Wood Elves, and play Scapeshift. It's not that unlikely, but. I don't really get anywhere by not playing aggressively. Especially not game one, you don't really have any trumps. Which is why game one is so bad for you. On the plus side, he doesn't have Scapeshift in hand if he doesn't cast it now. Which is good news. Of course, the bad news is probably has a counterspell, which is why I don't think I want to go for Tezzeret here. We'll play a Mox, though, to sacrifice to the Thopter Foundry. That's good, I suppose. Need to draw a combo piece to try to kill him before he draws Scapeshift. Alright, well, that's interesting. Still gonna be able to Valakut me for enough, but it means if I, with this Ghost Quarter, if I can start comboing soon here, which this Gifts will ideally allow me to do. I can Ghost Quarter Valakut and gain enough life that I don't die. That's a Courage Traveler's fine. Gotta save my spell snares at this point for his peers and remands. Drawing that gifts was pretty good. Hopefully it resolves. definitely getting that remand. So here, unfortunately, I can't just go for sword because I don't have an artifact to sacrifice and play. But sword, I can just go for sword and a bunch of zero mana artifacts. I don't think he's going to give me muddle or anything like that. Yeah, it seems fine. Mana leak isn't too useful. It's not going to give me a cryptic or anything like that. Sure, I'll get some zero mana artifacts. Doesn't give me Torment's Crypt, interesting. Not me to tap Ghost Quarter. Well, actually, doesn't actually matter this turn, because I still die this turn to Scapeshift. Take another hit. I want to be able to cryptic with Spell Snare backup, in case that matters. Hopefully does not have Scapeshift this turn. Alright. Now I think I should be okay. Because I can Ghost Quarter his Valakut if I need to. Which means with three mountains in play, he can, I don't think, do enough damage to kill me. Because even if he has 10 mountains in his deck, he can do 21 to me, and I'll be over 21 life. Which means if he goes for Escape Shift, yeah, I would not want to. Oop, he's about to show me his hand, and I just hit okay. Anyway, if he goes for Escape Shift, you don't want to fight over it, you just want to Ghost Quarter of Valakut, and then get enough life.